Good morning, saints of God. How are you doing today? Boy, isn't it good to be a saint of God? Isn't it good to know that our sins have been washed away and we have been set apart for the Master's use? Thank God for that glorious truth this morning. And thank God for the great services last night in the house of God. And thank God for His blessings and the fellowship of the brethren. Matter of fact, that's a little bit about what we're talking about here today, is coming to the place to where we have sincere fellowship with the brethren. We're in Romans chapter number 12, and we're going to look at verse number 15. And I pray that it will really be an encouragement to you. You know, we need a scripture every day. I'm convinced that I need a scripture every day, and you need a scripture every day. And that way we can grow in our spiritual walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. Powerful verse today. You know, a couple days ago we talked about the hospitality of a believer. Can anybody remember what that definition was? It was the love of strangers, okay? Well, today he's talking about sincerity. He's talking about being real. He's not talking about this plastic Christianity, you know, where, you know, you tell people, oh, I'll pray for you, but you never even pray. He's not talking about these people who will smile at you to your face, but stab you in the back. He's not talking about people who are like that. He comes along in this verse right here, and he reminds us that the Christian faith is sincere. And he really hits the nail on the head here. In Romans chapter number 12, and look at our verse today. There you go. Verse 15. It says, rejoice with them that do rejoice, and weep with them that weep. I know. As soon as we look at this verse, as soon as I read this verse, I said, oh, Lord, thank you. There's one I can do. And as we begin to look about it, and we begin to think it over, and we begin to let it soak into our lives, we begin to realize what he's talking about. He's talking about living with real sincerity, where people are what's important in your life, okay? It's not the things, it's not the job, it's not the vacations, it's not the getaways. And you know, it's coming to a place to where you realize that people are important. And you know, that's what it's all about, is people in our lives. The first thing he tells us here is that we need to learn to rejoice with those. Now that doesn't mean a wild party like rejoicing, okay? No, he's not talking about that right there. But he's talking about when our friends and our neighbors and our acquaintances, when something good happens to them in their lives, you and I ought to rejoice as if it happened to us. Why, you know, if a new baby came, well, that would be rejoicing. It'd be a miracle, but that would be a rejoicing. How about some great achievement? Or maybe somehow a promotion comes, or some kind of purchase happens for them. Somebody gets a new car. You know, sometimes it's hard. Now listen to this. Sometimes it's hard not to live with a little bit of envy, not to live with a little bit of, wait a second, when's it my turn to have a new car? When am I going to get my truck? You know, and what we've got to do is be careful, because here's what he's telling us. We need to be the kind of person who has no envy in our lives, but instead we are joyfully happy for the good that comes to all lives, and that we are good. We are happy for people when good things happen to them. We need to come to the place to where we sincerely don't feel disappointment, because we know and we trust God that He is working things out, and He knows exactly what I need, and therefore I don't need to be disappointed. And you know, because somebody got something that I didn't. Matter of fact, probably that's a sign of real Christian maturity. You know, it's kind of childish to constantly be comparing ourselves to others, and it causes us to act in a very indifferent way. He's saying, drop all those things. Drop that. Learn to rejoice with those that are rejoicing. Hey, that's what Jesus did. He rejoiced over them. Well, you know, I'll never forget weeping with those that weep and rejoice with those that weep. I'll get down to that in just a minute. And rejoice with those that are rejoicing. I'll never forget one day early in the pastorate, I came to a family. They were just having a baby. And boy, it was exciting. It was, you know, went into the room. It was their first child. And the little baby's name was Daniel. Then I went later on that day to another family in the church. And the grandfather had passed away. And they were weeping and grieving. And the man's name was Daniel. And, you know, you begin to see how God takes one and God brings one, and how that there's a rejoicing over here and there's weeping over here. And for us to have the ability to minister like we need to minister, we got to be able to have the heart that rejoices with those that are rejoicing. And at the same time, we have to weep with those that are weeping. And, you know, it definitely helps us to have real sincerity for people, because I want to tell you something. So many people go through so much where there's such sorrow, such suffering, such pain, such loss, such family hurt that goes on in life. And folks, there's not a better picture in the Word of God of the Holy Spirit than when you and I as God's children come along to our brothers and sisters and we help bear their burdens through the love of Christ. And that helps us out so much. So listen, there's you a powerful thought. There's you a good verse for you to think about. And mark her down. Learn to rejoice with those that are rejoicing and weep with those that are weeping. And it'll be a blessing to you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, help us to realize that the Christian faith ought to be sincere. And Father, we realize there's times in our lives when we've got to make some changes, Lord, that we have to work on the inside part, that, Father, truly we can be people who rejoice with those that are rejoicing. And truly, Father, give us the ability to carry our brother's burdens and help us to weep with those that are weeping. And, Father, help us to grow and be mature Christians. And, Father, help us to realize you've never cheated us to do us wrong so we can rejoice. And, Father, help us to realize that when we help our brothers and sisters in Christ carry their burdens, Lord, we are lighting the load for them. And Father, that they need our presence with sincerity, Father, with real love. Father, help us, we pray today in these areas. And Father, help us to serve you better, we pray, for we ask it in Jesus' name. All right, go serve. Where's that camera at? There you are. God bless you. Go serve your King. All right, we'll see you later. Bye-bye.